Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here comes the Jags offense now. Time for their first possession of half number two. They trail offense. First time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. They'll come out in the pistol. They'll try and get the run game going. This is Yeldon. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. It's a loss of five there, bringing up second.
When you put together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
They come up in an offset eye. They'll run it again with Yeldon. And he is going to lose yardage here. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. He's a second-round pick, a solid second-round pick. But when you're close to that first round, do you come in with a little chip on your shoulder?
You definitely do, because now your money's not the same. But even more than that, it's the prestige. Everyone wants to be a first-round pick, and he thought his talent demanded that. And I do know some teams in the league that first-round grades on it.
Really, it's a solid draft class from a year ago. They were able to address some key weak spots on their team and fill in some holes.
And they were able to identify the players they wanted early in the process. Got a little bit of luck, as some guys may have fallen to them. But for the most part, knew their philosophy and stuck to it.
Fielded at about the 28. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here. Finding time. Oh, man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Terrence Williams, 55 yards. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. And that touchdown reception is the fifth for him in this game, and that ties the NFL record.
And a record that's held up since 1950. This is another person that's tied it, but think about this. Bob Shaw said it in 1950. Kellen Winslow came along and tied it. And then, of course, Jerry Rice tied it as well. And finally, we're seeing it here one more time. Phenomenal.
And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Well, the offense wasn't out there for a long time, but they were out there for a good time. One play, and they're able to hit pay dirt. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The defense for the Cowboys getting set to go. They were able to force that three and out. That led to a touchdown. Defenses obviously love three and outs. They want more of that.
They created a very short and not too sweet stint for the offense by getting them off the field that fast, but it set up their own offense, gave them a little spark, and they took it downfield and scored.
Now the question, can they do it again? Let's see. They go play action for Yeldon. Now it's Bortles. Trying to get it to Robinson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Orlando Scandrick. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got two extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down. Well, so they just got the football on an interception. They almost gave it right back the same way.
And you know, when you look over to the bench after that type of a play, number one is pure relief. Didn't give it up. But it's not the coach you're worried about yelling at you. It's those guys on defense who just intercepted the pass who want a break over there. Hey, take care of the football, man.
He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. Touchdown, Cowboys! Terrence Williams, 40 yards. And the Cowboys turn that interception into a touchdown. And that, boys and girls, is an NFL record. Sixth touchdown reception. The record has stood since 1950. What a game.
How about that? Because so many things have to go right in order for it to happen. Not just him catching the passes, someone delivering it accurately, offensive line giving them time to throw the ball. A true team record, but he stands above it because he was on the receiving end of so many great plays.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Down carry now for Yeldon. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Decent chunk of yardage still left here. Second and 7. Again, it's Yeldon. And he'll get about 4 across the 30 to the 32.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
Here's the option going right. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down. And yet again, this run game just continues to be completely shut off.
Completely stymied. I mean, they're trying to get some consistency, trying to find places to roam. They just haven't been there throughout this game.
And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. This is brought in at the 21. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. So second and 10 here. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Play clock winding down. Throwing again. Prescott on second and 10. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Go down. Extra defensive back in there on third and 10. And is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. Their passing game has been spectacular this afternoon. Finally, a win for the defense.
You think maybe there was an adjustment there. Finally gained a measure of, I don't even know if you call it revenge, but got a play done against him, and that's been difficult for them all game long.
Now Bortles will give to Yeldon, and he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Oftentimes when you're not winning at the point of attack for an offensive line, maybe they're getting out physical. Spread things out a little bit, make it more of a one-on-one blocking scheme. Then you don't have to win it physically. You just have to win it by position. That may open things up for your running backs.
Give them 4 on the carry there, but that only takes them back to where they started. 3rd and 10.
Well, so far, this game has gone the way the defensive coordinator had hoped. They've dictated things. They've not let them run the ball very well at all. They gave up a nice game there. I doubt it'll back off their confidence. They've played so well throughout this entire game.
To throw, it's Bortles. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds.
Holding offense.
Here's Brad Nordman now, as they're forced to kick for the 6th time today. Here's Brad Nordman now, as he's on to punt for Jacksonville. He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And this one's out of bounds. Should be inside the 10, I think it is, at the 6-yard line. Dallas gets set to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He was looking for Terrence Williams that time. And that'll bring up second down. Second down here after the incomplete pass.
Come on, let's go!
On second down, Prescott again. Rolling to his left. Now he's going to throw deep back over the middle. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third. And now it looks like we've got a Cowboy shaking up down there on the field. Hate to see this. Week 1 of the season. We'll be back. The Jags have 5 in the secondary here on third down. Romo. He's got his man. It's Williams. And he's going to get this one all the way up to the 30. A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion.
Well, go ahead and throw the ball, man. You got the big lead. You got the clock on your side. Obviously, they don't care much about the feelings of the other team, do they?
Well, I was going to say, you better run to the locker room pretty quick after this one.
Well, right now, maybe. They're just looking at it from the fantasy perspective. More points for everyone if they win big.
On first down, Romo. Sliding out of the pocket. Now on the run. He'll throw. And that's caught inside the 30. It's a big play. Romo to Bryant. 44 yards.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.